Hello, this is Bern, and if you, yes, you, secretly compare yourself to other women, and you hate it, and it makes you feel horrible, on today's episode, I'm going to share with you a way out. So stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great life to be.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, gorgeous and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams and create the connection with the kind of man you want without the need for gimmicks or manipulation or crazy techniques or games. Now, as I shared in my intro, if you're someone who sometimes feels the big, heavy, horrible weight of someone you feel is younger than you, sexier than you, more beautiful than you, thinner than you, curvier than you, whatever it is that you're comparing yourself to, and it's driving you insane and it's making you feel like shit. On today's episode, I'm gonna share with you a few principles that can help you turn this around once and for all. First one is, I'm just gonna share this from my heart. Having been a man who, unlike other guys, for whatever reason, because this is what I do for a living, helping women find love, have had thousands of deep one-on-one conversations with women from every color, shape, size, ethnicity, nationality, I can tell you that it is so simple to be a supernova. Supernova means that gigantic explosion of a star that fills the room with light. I'm not saying it's easy, but it's simple, because what you need to be a supernova, more than building and adding things into your life, is removing the excess weight of fear, removing the excess weight of unworthiness, removing the excess weight of I'm not good enough, removing the excess weight of pain from your past, opening your heart. And as I said, it's not easy to do those things, but it's a simple process. You just have to let go of stuff that doesn't serve you, and then you can shine with more radiance and more light and more beauty. The beauty that you have inside combines with the beauty that you have outside, and if they get together, it's exponentially stronger than if you just do one or the other. Okay? Second one is, I need you to focus on what I'm going to name right now your superpowers. Why? Because there's going to be women who are better than you in pretty much any area you can think of. They'll be better than you in that one thing. But the combination of who you are, the precise thumbprint, which is unique, no one has your same thumbprint, the specific combination of spices and essences that makes up who you are, is what makes you incredibly attractive to the right guy. So, and incredibly attractive to you and to life and to human beings who want to hang out with you, not necessarily just to be your boyfriend or husband, but to bask in your greatness and to help you out. So your superpowers, when you focus on your superpowers, that means focusing on your strengths, focusing on that one part of you that is slightly more sexy than the other ones, that part of you that's more in tune with life than the other ones, that part, that habit, that way of looking at life, that characteristic, that virtue that makes you such, that makes you you. That makes you shine. So when you focus on those things, instead of trying to come up with ways of filling up all the different voids that you have in your life, when you go all in on your superpowers, you can shine so much more brightly and you can be that supernova that I'm talking about. So focus on your superpowers instead of trying to be the jack of all trades. You don't have to. All you have to do is shine and be strong in the things that you are strong in. Now, I'm not saying you should not want to improve in other things, but you shouldn't feel like you have to be a perfect woman to create the kind of relationship you want, to attract an incredible man who wants to love you and adore you and kiss you and make love to you every single day. Like, you don't have to be a superwoman. You have to connect with your own unique superpowers, which is different, okay? Number three, the sexiest thing in a woman is her openness. The sexiest thing, it's not the size of her butt, it's not the size of her breasts, it's not the cadence of her hips, it's the openness that she brings to the table. It's so subtle. It's the way you smile, the way that you look at him with two extra seconds. It's the, it's just everything that makes you expand from the inside out and shine a little bit more light makes you incredibly sexier. So if you want to be sexier, not just to attract an amazing man, but to not die with your music inside of you, because you have it inside and it's boiling and it needs to be expressed, then focus on opening, focus on openness, focus on connecting with that which you have. Fourth, one of the most inspiring things you can bring to the table, and not just inspiring in terms of somebody saying, isn't she great, she's admirable, but inspiring in terms of inspiring commitment from a man, is your ability to remain courageous under your vulnerability. That means when you feel vulnerable, having the courage to speak your truth when your voice is shaking, having the capacity to hold space for him when you want to run away, but you know that the thing to do is to wait for an extra couple of seconds and state a boundary, or share a need, or share a story from your past that will make him understand what's going on in your life right now. That type of courage under the deepest vulnerability creates the deepest inspiration, makes you the most inspiring source of awesomeness in his life. Fifth step is, I need you to recognize that the most beautiful thing in you is your radiance. The most beautiful thing in you is your capacity, as we talked about, like the openness, right? That makes you create sexiness. Well, the radiance component of it creates beauty, creates the capacity for someone to see you from 7 miles away and feel something, hit him in the chest and arrest him, literally, and have no other option but to get close to you, connect with you, ask for your number, ask you on a date, take you to the next date, and go all the way. Six, I want you to understand that love isn't a competition, okay? What you're going for is resonance, not competition. So that means that if there's a woman who has, is taller or has a stronger butt or something, I mean, like that you feel would be a disqualifying factor for you, it makes no difference, because imagine that you have a specific key. And that key could be longer or shorter, blue or green. It can be brass or it could be chrome. If it's the right type of key, it will open the man's heart. If you have another key that's a different color, different shape, different size, that key may not open the man's heart, regardless of it being gold or being diamond chipped or something. Because what a guy is looking for is a specific set of feelings that he gets from you. So if you stop comparing yourself, if you stop feeling like you have to compete against other women, if you understand that the right resonance, the right energy, the right magnetism blows him away in such a way that he needs to take action, then you stop trying to compete without some, it's not a competition. Your specific thumbprint, as I spoke about, is what makes the biggest difference. Seventh and last, the alternative to comparing yourself to other women stems from a fullness of being. Fullness of being means the capacity for you to self-express instead of pushing things down. To speak your truth when you want to sometimes not speak your truth because it's scary, because he might run away. Fullness of being means choosing to shine light when you need to instead of dimming your own light. Hope this is helpful, insightful, and useful. And if it is, I'm gonna ask you, beautiful, awesome lady, to do three things. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video so more human beings can watch it. Number two, subscribe to my channel and click the bell if you want to be notified of new episodes as they come out. Three, and most important of all, if you're digging this content and you want to take it to the next level in terms of understanding what does it really take to enter the best relationship of your life, I've created a masterclass that's totally free. All you have to do is go to the first link on the description of this video, enter your name and email, and you'll be immediately redirected to that masterclass. If you're watching this and you're saying, Bern, I'd love to get your own specific help, hand-holding, accountability, second link on the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life. Number 7.